So it's like double almost. You know, you get look in your POH, pilot operating handbook, and you can check to see how much runway you're going to use, what your climb rate's going to be. So if you're up in Denver, you know, I mean, I know we do, when we're doing mic check rides, we always try to use like Centennial Airport in Denver. I do anyway. And that's close to 6,000 feet above sea level.
Yep.
So looking at your takeoff distance, it's like 1,700 to 1,800 or something like that.
Yep. Up at 6,000 or 7,000 feet.
So it's like double almost.
Cool. It's a very big difference.
And I mean, this is in a little Cessna. So, I mean, you could apply that to any airplane, you know, it's going to be double the distance. But then you have to look at after takeoff, the climb rate. You know, you're starting out at 6,000 feet. You probably want to climb to 9,000 because you're, so you can stay 3,000 feet above the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And then that climb rate will, I mean, at 6,000, you're probably getting, what was it, like three or 400 feet a minute, somewhere around there.
Yeah.
And then it just slowly gets worse as you go try to climb. So,
yeah, because the airplane's behaving like it's at that. Well, I guess in that case, it's at that altitude. But say we were here at Lafayette, they report density altitude 3,000 or something like that on a crazy hot day. The aircraft's going to behave like it's at 3,000. So that performance is reduced heavily.